Mr. Dean, I present to you Benjamin Sharp to be promoted to the position of leading chorister in this cathedral choir.
Mr. Rushforth, I thank you for your presentation. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I admit you, Ben, as a leading chorister. You must always try and see that what you sing and say with your lips is consistent with what you believe in your heart. And what you believe in your heart is practiced in your life, day by day, wherever you are. Let us pray. O Lord God Almighty, whose being and majesty surpass all that our minds can conceive or our lips can tell, and who in every generation has drawn us to bring the skills of music to offer you praise and glory, bless those who sing in this place, that with heart and mind they may make melody to you and so lead our praises, that together we may magnify your glorious name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Good afternoon to all of you and a warm welcome to the choir at Chester Cathedral, whether you're here in person or whether you join us online. We gather for the office of Choral Evensong. Today is the 70th anniversary of the accession of Queen Elizabeth II to the throne. So an accidental day, in that she acceded to the throne on the day her father died. She was actually in Kenya at the time. And so for her, this is a bittersweet day. In our worship this afternoon, we will give thanks for the 70 years of stability that we have endured whilst she has been Queen of these Isles. Our opening hymn, can be found in the New English Hymnal at number 352. We will omit verse 2. Omit verse 2. Crown him with many crowns. Psalms appointed for this afternoon are Psalms 32 and 33. The first reading is written in the first chapter of the book of the prophet Hosea, beginning to read at the first verse. The word of the Lord that came to Hosea, son of Beeri, in the days of kings Uzziah, Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah of Judah, and in the days of King Jeroboam, son of Joash of Israel. When the Lord first spoke through Hosea, the Lord said to Hosea, "Go, take for yourself a wife of whoredom, and have children of whoredom, for the land commits great whoredom by forsaking the Lord." So he went and took Gomer, daughter of Diblaim, and she conceived and bore him a son. And the Lord said to him, "Name him Jezreel, for in a little while I will punish the house of Jehu for the blood of Jezreel, and I will put an end to the kingdom of the house of Israel. On that day I will break the bow of Israel in the valley of Jezreel." She conceived again and bore a daughter. The Lord said to him, "Name her Lo-Ruhamah, for I will no longer have pity on the house of Israel or forgive them, but I will have pity on the house of Judah, and I will save them by the Lord their God. I will not save them by bow or by sword or by war or by horses or by horsemen." When she had weaned Lo-Ruhamah, she conceived and bore a son. Then the Lord said, "Name him Lo-Ami, for you are not many people, and I am not your God. Yet the number of people of Israel shall be like the sand of the sea, which can be neither measured nor numbered. And in the place where it was said to them, 'You are not my people,' it shall be said to them, 'Children of the living God.' The people of Judah and the people of Israel shall be gathered together, and they shall appoint for themselves one head, and they shall take possession of the land, for great shall be the day of Jezreel." Here ends the first reading.
Thank you.
The second reading is written in the third chapter of the letter to the Colossians, beginning to read at the first verse. So, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, whatever in you is earthly: fornication, impurity, passion, evil desire, and greed, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming on those who are disobedient. These are the ways you also once followed when you were living that life. But now you must get rid of all such things: anger, wrath, malice, slander, and abusive language from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have stripped off the old self with its practices and have clothed yourselves with the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge according to the image of its creator. In that renewal, there is no longer Greek and Jew, circumcised and uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave and free, but Christ is all and in all. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, be subject to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and never treat them harshly. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this is your acceptable duty in the Lord. Fathers, do not provoke your children, or they may lose heart. Slaves, obey your earthly masters in everything, not only while being watched, and in order to please them, but wholeheartedly fearing the Lord. Here ends the second reading.
Thank you.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
The anthem is a setting of the Te Deum, Te Deum in C by John Rutter.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We follow the form of prayer prescribed in the Book of Common Prayer for Accession Day, praying first for the safety of Her Majesty the Queen. O Lord our God, who upholdest and governest all things by the word of thy power, receive our humble prayers for our Sovereign Lady Elizabeth, as on this day set over us by the grace and providence to be our Queen. And together with her, bless Charles, Prince of Wales, and all the royal family, that they, ever trusting in thy goodness, protected by thy power, and crowned with thy gracious and endless favour, may long continue before thee in peace and safety, joy and honour, and after death may obtain everlasting life and glory by the merits and mediation of Christ Jesus our Saviour, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth ever one God, world without end. Amen. And we pray for the welfare of this nation and all who live here. Almighty God, who rulest over all the kingdoms of the world, and dost order them according to thy good pleasure, we yield thee unfeigned thanks for that thou wast pleased as on this day to set thy servant, our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, upon the throne of this realm. Let thy wisdom be her guide and thine arm strengthen her. Let truth and justice, holiness and righteousness, peace and charity abound in her days. Direct all her counsels and endeavours to thy glory and the welfare of her subjects. Give us grace to obey her cheerfully for conscience' sake. And let her always possess the hearts of her people. Let her reign be long and prosperous, and crown her with everlasting life in the world to come. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray in these turbulent times for good government. We pray for the security of Europe and for peace between East and West. O God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, our only Saviour, the Prince of Peace, give us grace seriously to lay to heart the great dangers we are in by our unhappy divisions. Take away all hatred and prejudice, and whatsoever else may hinder us from godly union and concord, that, as there is but one body and one spirit and one hope of our calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of us all, so we may henceforth be all of one heart and of one soul, united in one holy bond of truth and peace, of faith and charity, and may with one mind and one mouth glorify thee, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray for our own needs, holding them before God, and those who suffer and those who grieve, especially in those situations where we're not sure how to pray, but we know God's love is sought. Almighty God, the fountain of all wisdom, who knowest our necessities before we ask, and our ignorance in asking, we beseech thee to have compassion upon our infirmities, and those things which for our unworthiness we dare not, and for our blindness we cannot ask, vouchsafe to give us for the worthiness of thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We conclude by praying for each other as we say together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore. Amen. Our second hymn in the hymn books is number 443. Rejoice, the Lord is King. God, grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth and all people, unity, peace and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen.